And that brings us to our next question about the Surface Go. And this one comes in from IAMRLK69, who does comment quite frequently here on the channel. He wanted to know what my long-term impressions were of this device. And I have to say, they've been very good. What's funny is that I use this more as a PC than I do as a tablet. It's very easy to put into tablet mode, of course. You just pull the keyboard off and it will switch into that mode. But I really just don't like the Windows tablet interface. I just prefer it to be a PC. And what's nice about this is that I'm often having to do stuff in Windows, and it's so nice to have a little device that I can keep on my desk and grab when I need it to format a drive or to get some utility loaded up or do some kind of product preview or whatever. It's just a very convenient PC. It performs good enough, just like the MacBook does, to do most of those tasks without any problems. And I've been very, very pleased with it, not only for its form factor, but its battery life and just the overall user experience with it. I did sell the pen. I don't use the pen at all. I use my iPad for that. And I always keep the keyboard attached here as well, because it's just helpful as a PC to be a full and complete device. It, like the MacBook, only has that single USB-C port, but you can power it separately. So that does provide a little bit more flexibility. And I have the choice as to how I want to power it. So if I don't want to take the power adapter with me, I can just use a USB-C power device. I can use my little hub thing or one of the other devices I have, or just fire it up directly. The other thing that I like about it is that it works really well in my video workflow. Let me show you an example of that. Now, one thing that really surprised me about the Surface Go was how well it handles NDI video, both sending and receiving. Now, if you're not familiar with NDI, it's a means of transmitting video over the network into your production environment. It works with my TriCaster here, of course, but you can also use it with OBS. In fact, we did that the other night when we did our VR live stream. It is so easy. You load up this little app and the screen is just available to devices across the network. And it works great on this device because it has an Intel processor with QuickSync built in. So as you can see here, I can do product demos. I can do whatever I need to do here on the Surface Go. And if I have a Windows app that I want to show off in a video, I'm able to do that. Again, it's not the fastest thing in the world here. You can see how long it took for Chrome to load up on it, but it's good enough for getting a lot of things done. And in addition to sending NDI video, it also works well as an NDI monitor. So I can say hello to everybody here and just be able to use this to monitor what my TriCaster is outputting in different parts of the room. And that can be really helpful because we have a chroma key screen over there. And rather than drag the monitor over from the TriCaster, I can just set this thing up. I've got a little stand with wheels and a mounting bracket, and I can have it just sit there as a monitor. And it even works well over Wi-Fi for that. Although for transmitting, I like to have the Ethernet attached to it. So it's great as a little monitor. It's great as a screen sharing device, and it runs Windows apps well. It's not going to design the next great engineering feat or some crazy thing like that, but it will do most of the basic Windows apps without issue, and that's generally what we do here on the channel. So it's great for that. I love the form factor. I just love having a Windows computer always at hand, and that is exactly what this device has done for me.
This channel is brought to you by the Lon.TV supporters, including gold-level supporters, the Four Guys with Quarters podcast, Tom Albrecht, Brian Parker, and Kalyan Kumar. If you want to help the channel, you can by contributing as little as $1 a month. Head over to lon.tv/support to learn more. And don't forget to subscribe. Visit lon.tv/s.